Hey guys, how's it going? Welcome back to Let's Play Diablo 2. Let's finish up Act. Let's finish up Act 2.
The Archangel Tyriel was the one who gave the Soul Stones to the Herodrum 260 years ago. It is highly unusual for the forces of heaven to so directly interfere with man's destiny, but Tyriel was said to act of his own volition. We have never been able to discern why. Perhaps he goes against the consensus of heaven because he doubts our ability to defend ourselves. Or perhaps he sees more threat than his peers. Where the actions of hell often seem straightforwardly bent on destruction, the motives of heaven are unfathomable. Now make haste. Both Diablo and Baal must be stopped before they join with their brother Mephisto. If the three prime evils unite once again, the world as we know it will be no more.
This is terrible news. Baal is in possession of one of mankind's most powerful mages, and the Lord of Terror guides his path. They must be stopped, for I am sure they mean to free their elder brother Mephisto, the Lord of Hatred, who lies imprisoned under the corrupted city of Kurast. I fear you are walking into a great evil, but your faith can save you. May you walk in the light always.
Thank you. You have anything to say?
I'm sorry things didn't turn out as you had hoped. Go and remember us fondly. You know, you bothered me far less than most.
Thanks.
You have done very well. Few could have come this far, let alone discover the true tomb of Talrasha. Unfortunately, I hear that Diablo and Baal have eluded your grasp. This is most unfortunate. If you wish to travel east, I have authorized Mashif to give you passage by sea. I imagine he should be very anxious to leave by now. Good luck on your quest, and thank you again for saving my beloved city. You will always be welcome in Lut Golain, my friend.
Yeah, you're welcome. And then type him. Let's mess with my belt. Oops. Actually, this one. Chief is down here. It'll be fine. Eerie music. My favorite kind.
My companion blew in the dank, cold air of the tomb. It seemed to strengthen him. I stood in the doorway to enlighten and lock. What was left of my sanity implored me not to enter. But that voice was just a whisper now. As we worked our way down, deeper and deeper into the crypt, I began to see a change in my companion. He seemed to be gaining. Then I realized my companion hadn't been gaining strength. He had been losing what was left of his humanity.
to imagine what you've set in motion this day. Go to the Temple of Light in the eastern city of Karas. There you will find the gate to hell opened before you. You must find the courage to step through that gate, Maras. Take the stone you hold to the Hellforge, where it will be destroyed. Now run. Take the stone and run!
Yeah, here we are, Act 3. How's it going?
Welcome to Karas, traveler. You come willingly to this ancient city anymore. I hope you brought your wits with you, for sanity is in short supply here. My name is Hratli. I am a sorcerer skilled in metalwork. It'd be a pleasure to help you. I don't have many customers these days. As you can see, the populace has been brutally decimated by the forces of Mephisto. The canals run red with blood, and demons roam the land. The wretched jungle hell has already reclaimed much of Karas. The only safety you'll find is here at the dark side, where a magical warden holds the jungle evils at bay. But I don't know how long. To make matters worse, the children of Zakrum are in league with the forces of Mephisto. The Zakrum have concentrated their power in the temple city of Travancore, located within Karas deep in the jungle wilderness. It's true, their zeal is unmatched, but I say the so-called warriors of light are nothing more than the twisted puppets of a hidden hand.
What do you got? Yeah, nothing. Anyways, let's look at what this place looks like in the old style. Yeah. This, that's more like it. Very nostalgic. Alright, what's up, Deckard?
Must be Mephisto's work. You'd best get going, my friend. Diablo and Bale are still out there, and you must find them.
No problem, dude. Well, why not? I'll do this real quick. There we go. Yeah, right now we don't really have any quests to do. We're just gonna go into Act 3 and explore.
I wish you people would just leave me alone. You're new here, aren't you? I am Alcor the Alchemist. I dabble in potions and salves. And I can sell you some if you really need them. But don't make a habit of coming here. I don't like to be disturbed while I'm studying.
What was on your floor? That is a cow's head. Okay. Okay, you just got crap.
Hello there. You must be a great adventurer to risk coming here. My name's Ashira, and I lead the mercenary band of mages known as the Iron Wolves. We've been hunting down demons in the jungle for months, but no matter how many of them we kill, they just keep coming. Seems this whole place has been overrun by evil. Rumor has it that you've come here to help. If that's true, then I'll let you hire some of my mercenaries. But be careful. You piss them off, they can be worse than those monsters out in the jungle.
It'll be okay. Hire my guy back. Okay, let's go to like the southern part. I guess eastern, depending on how you look at it.
Greetings, hero. I've heard of your exploits and I'm quite impressed. Very few mortals are capable of dealing with the three and their minions as you have. My name is Natalia. I am a hunter of evil, part of an ancient order sworn to hunt down corrupted sorcerers. If I could, I would gladly join your quest to stop the three. But I must wait here for further news. I can't predict what will happen, but the danger is greater than we can know. Until I receive my orders, I'll assist you with the information I have. Ashira? Well, she's a tough-talking mage, but I'd wager she's never faced true evil. Pampering drunken mercenaries is one thing, but standing face-to-face with a hellspawn demon is another.
Last but not least. Oh, wait. The guy that we talked to at the beginning, he goes over there at some point. That's what I was thinking of.
You now speak to Ormus. He was once a great mage, but now lives like a rat in a sinking vessel. You have questions for Ormus and doubt in yourself. Ormus sees a strange dichotomy in you, as he does in all would-be heroes. Speak to him, and he may grant you wisdom in turn, or turn from him and seek wisdom in thyself.
Trade, yeah, this guy's the potion guy. There we go. Finally got some better potions. Hey, Dark Wanderer. Oh, yeah. Oh, dang it. So, yeah, let's just start Act 3 by exploring it. Like I said, we don't really have any quests right now. So let's just explore good old Act 3, which can be fun to get around with how many things there are around. What is my attack rating? 90% to hit those guys? Okay. Pick something up I don't want. Ouch! Okay. Some new enemies. I mean, I think we encountered the fetish guys in Act 1. Sometimes, those guys don't always show up near the end of Act 1, so I don't really remember. Pretty sure we did. Oh, something dropped. Oh, sure, give me the key. I'll tell you though, the first like objective we have to do is kill a unique enemy, and it should drop our first quest item. So we just gotta kind of walk around until we come across a unique guy. I mean, I'm pretty sure you can, like, do the other, like, actual story objectives without actually having them in your book or in your log. So if you wanted to, you could totally go. If you, you know, played the game before and you know where you're going, go ahead, you know. Nothing's stopping you. But since I plan on doing all the quests and everything, I think it'd be a good idea to maybe you know, do things the way I'm supposed to do things. Let's take a look at how things look in Legacy. Yeah, it's pretty jungly. Definitely like the way things look in the new graphics. Looks pretty good. I want to go that way. Don't think there's really a reason to. Yeah. But who knows, maybe I'll come across a, something. So all I want is something. He, Arachnid Lair, yeah. But hey, we got a... I don't think there's anything in here. Pretty sure this is not the one I'm thinking of. Jewel, though. Because I'm like 99% sure this is not the cave I'm looking for. But hey, you know, just kill stuff, I guess. Oh no. Well, looks like now this is the perhaps it's worth something. That is indeed the first item we need for the quest, for our first quest. Get rid of these. Since greater healing potions are starting to drop, I'm going to start getting rid of light healing potions. All right, you asked Kane about the jade figurine. Well, there we go. There we go.
Back in Lutgolane, Meshif told me he had a fondness for jade figurines. On his trading voyages, he collected an odd assortment of such small statues. I would show him your figurine.
Okay.
Good evening.
Yeah. Meshif is over here.
Well, I gave you my word and brought you here as promised. But by all that's still holy, I wish I'd never returned to this accursed place. This fetid jungle can't be the fair Kurost I left behind. I don't know what all this evil is, my friend, but it's obvious that you must stop it. I only pray that you can before the jungle consumes the last vestiges of my beloved homeland. Praise you. That jade figurine will complete the set I was collecting. Here, I've had this statuette of a golden bird for years, but I consider it a fair exchange.
Ask Cain about the bird.
I've read legends about a sage named Kuile, who studied the mysteries of life beyond death. If I remember correctly, his ashes were ensconced within a golden statuette. It was a very strange tale.
Alcor, yeah, it's this guy over here.
Ah, the golden bird of Kuile. Thank you, my friend. Busy yourself while I experiment with the ashes within it. Then return and see what I've made for you.
I'm turning to Alcor. All right, I'm gonna buy another mana potion, just for the heck of it. And sell that.
Yes.
I don't want to talk to you. No. Okay.
From the ashes of Kuile, I have mixed for you a potion.
There we go. What does it do? Gives us permanent 20 health. Hell yeah. 20 life is good.
Never forget that your ultimate purpose here in Kurost is to destroy Mephisto. The ancient Horothrim imprisoned the Lord of Hatred inside the Guardian Tower that is located within the Temple City of Travancore. Know this, friend. The only way to gain entry to Mephisto's prison is to destroy the artifact known as the Compelling Orb. Mephisto used this device to control the Zakharum priests and their followers. The orb can only be destroyed with an ancient flail imbued with the spirit of the one incorruptible priest. Soon after his imprisonment, Mephisto worked his evil corruption on the Zakharum priesthood. All were turned to his dark ways, save one, Kalim, the K-Hagan of the High Council. Mephisto directed the other council priests to slay and dismember Kalim, and then scatter his remains across the kingdom. The priest Sankakur succeeded Kalim as K-Hagan, eventually becoming the embodiment of Mephisto here on the mortal plane. The corrupted High Council fashioned an orb to control the rest of the Zakharum faithful and used their powers to hide the lair of their master from mortals. Your task is to collect the scattered relics of Kalim, his heart, his brain, and his eye. Then, using the Horodric Cube, transmute Kalim's flail with his relics. Once this is accomplished, you must destroy the compelling orb with Kalim's will to open the way into the corrupt sanctum of Mephisto.
There we go. Now we finally have our objective. Find Kalim's relic. Search for his eye in the spider cavern. So that's... Now we finally have our... A real objective here, and it's going to be pretty similar to what we did in Act 2, where we're looking for things to make a thing, to get to a thing. So, yeah, that's what we're, so that's what we'll be getting into next time. So, see you guys then.